You got me going in circles. Oh, round and round.
Yeah, you know I get money.
Is it legal?
Are you trying to profile me or something? Yes, I cut lawns all weekend long.
Wow, you know how to cut grass? Look at that.
What is this, misogynoir 101 or biology?
I don't know what this class is, to be honest.
I saw your own lawn at your house. That grass was brown and dried up.
Right, looking like the, what's that biome? The savanna. It was looking like the savanna from Lion King.
Well, it probably just needs some fertilizer.
What does that do? I've never really known.
I have no clue.
I've never known either.
Well, we all know that all living things
depend on each other in the environment to survive.
Well, how do living things depend on each other?
We eat each other or plants, right?
Right, but that second part, we haven't truly talked about. How do we depend on the environment?
I mean, we live in it, right?
Okay, so is that all? Just shelter, that's all we need it for?
Yeah.
Well, think of the water that you drink daily. Did that come from other organisms? Or think about the air that we breathe in. Did that come from other organisms?
No. Well, I mean, kind of, yeah.
Water and many of the other nutrients that you need to survive, yes, they can be obtained from other organisms, but they all originate from our environment. Either from the atmosphere or on the surface of Earth or under the Earth, and we all work together to cycle it through our ecosystem. Now, we know that organisms need energy to survive, so populations can grow, and we get that energy from food, but we don't need everything that exists on the Earth. There are only 6 crucial nutrients or elements that we need to survive. Chomps. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, and sulfur. And each of these are cycled through the environment in a variety of ways. Now, these cycles can get complex, so we'll just focus on how they are taken out of the environment and how they're put back into the environment. So, carbon makes up so many structures in our bodies, but where do we get it?
From our food, mainly from plants.
Right. When plants take in carbon dioxide from the atmosphere during...
photosynthesis.
Yes. This carbon dioxide also dissolves directly into bodies of water. When these organisms die, they decompose and become a part of the Earth again and remain there for millions of years. But when we're living, what things put carbon back into the environment?
Well, cell respiration. We breathe out carbon dioxide back into the environment.
Absolutely. And besides breathing out, I mean, we do some other things all of the time, every day, especially over the past 200 years that put carbon back into the environment.
Oh, like burning fossil fuels with pollution and whatnot?
Absolutely. And then plants take it back out of the environment and the cycle starts all over again. Now, hydrogen and oxygen, we know we need those for cell respiration and several other things in our bodies, but where does it come from?
The air, right?
Believe it or not, no.
What?
Well, I mean, it's there, but most of our oxygen and hydrogen comes from photosynthetic organisms that exist in water.
Oh, duh, like H2O.
Yes, so precipitation takes water out of the environment, and it runs off from our mountains into rivers, lakes, and streams, and into our oceans. Water is put back into the environment through the evaporation of those bodies of water and transpiration of plants as water vapor. And of course, when that gas gets cold enough in the atmosphere, it condenses.
Oh, condensation.
Yep, and it falls back down as precipitation and the cycle starts all over again.
I could have sworn we were supposed to be talking about fertilizer.
Well, speaking of precipitation, thunderstorms are very important for this next nutrient, nitrogen. Nitrogen is the most abundant gas in our atmosphere, and we can't use any of it.
What?
Well, we can't use any of it without help. The nitrogen cycle gets very complicated, so please know this is an abbreviated version.
Hey, I'm always here for the cliff notes.
Right, like he's gonna be doing all that talking. Ain't nobody trying to hear him. For...
Y'all know what those are? Anyway,
yeah.
When lightning strikes, it splits nitrogen gas so it can be taken out of the atmosphere by bacteria. And they fix it into a form that can be used by plants. The plants absorb it, and of course, yes, animals will eat the plants, and that's how we get nitrogen for our DNA and all proteins in our bodies. When those organisms die, they decompose back into the soil, bacteria will convert their nitrogen back into nitrogen gas, and it goes back into the atmosphere. Now, these last two, there's very little sulfur found in the atmosphere, and there's no phosphorus in the atmosphere at all.
Okay, well, then where is it?
Well, the little bit of sulfur we have in the air comes out of the atmosphere through acid rain. But majority of our phosphorus and sulfur comes out of the atmosphere through the erosion and weathering of rocks and mountains over time. It goes into the soil and is taken up by plants. In that same old process, the animals eat plants, we eat other animals, and when we all die, we go back to the soil. And that sulfur goes into coal and other fossil fuels. But phosphorus and sulfur will turn into new rocks underground and resurface as mountains or smaller rocks or volcanoes. And the cycle starts
all over again. It's a cycle, Mickens. We know
okay,
what that
good,
means.
Good.
Wait, so plants have to wait for rocks to form and for bacteria to work just to get nitrogen, phosphorus, and sulfur? Like, dang, that's a lot of weight.
And I thought they were supposed to be independent or whatever.
Well, you know, eventually they do get it, but just like you, if you were to have more of those nutrients, you'll be healthier and live much longer to survive. And that's why we have fertilizer. It contains phosphorus, sulfur, and nitrogen so that plants don't have to work as hard to get it. Our crops can grow and we can get more bountiful food so that animals can also survive and thrive.
Ah, okay, that's clear.
Well, my lawn business is really about to thrive now.
Yes, please get some nutrients cycling through that burnt up grass at your house.
You need to get some nutrients cycling through those burnt, dried up locks you got over there.
Hey,
you've
man.
Been taken out or redone.
Hey, don't be talking about nobody's hair.
The same style past weeks.